All right, class, we have come towards the end. I know you guys are excited to learn about our last articulation joint of the scapula. It is called the glenohumeral joint. The glenohumeral joint connects when the head of the humerus connects to the glenoid cavity of the scapula. This is due because the glenoid cavity is a shallow area where the head of the humerus is able to fit in. However, it is not stable, and it is one of the weakest part, but it allows for greater movement. And when the movements that is allowed due to the glenohumeral joints is flexion, extension, hyperextension, abduction, adduction, lateral rotate, medial rotate, and circumduction, which is a combination movement of all, which is flexion, extension, hyperextension, adduction, abduction, lateral, medial. So it's like a circle. And here is the diagram of where the head of the humerus connects with the glenoid cavity of the scapula. We had a scenario where Fred, a fireman, is fighting a fire in a building. Part of the ceiling collapsed, and a beam strike him on the left shoulder. He is rescued, but has a great deal of pain in his shoulder. He cannot move his arm properly, especially in interior direction. His clavicle is not broken. His humerus is intact. What is the probable nature of Fred's injury? I think what occurred to Fred is that because the glenoid joint is not stable, when the beam fell down on him, it caused dislocated his shoulder, and that's why his clavicle was not affected by the injury. Thank you so very much.